Good evening, everyone. Namaskar and welcome to today's event. I'm Sona and I'm really, really honored to be hosting today's event. Today really is a very special occasion where we celebrate the really special work of a very special person. And I make no apologies for using the word special so many times. Sometimes, you know, only one word really does it right. So I'm going to use that word a few times this evening. Today really is a, you know, I never thought I'd say this in London, but thank you all for coming out in a hot sunny day. You know, it's really remarkably hot, and I've had a lot of people ring me and say, so sorry, we've got a heat stroke, but thank you all for being here. So, all of this this exhibition is themed around stories. So I'm going to start off with a little story, if you don't mind, it's a very small one. So this story is about a little girl
who really loved her mother. And, you know, all kids think their mothers are special, and mothers are truly special, but this girl felt her mother was more special than all the other mothers. And it was really because of the way her mother brought her up, the values that her mother gave her, and the way she gave her those values. You know, telling her about all the traditions, and why we do things that we're doing, and where she couldn't justify it, she won't force her daughter to follow anything. And all of these lessons really helped that young girl, as she grew up in life, to deal with life and become a better person and become a successful person. So when this girl grew up, you know, she had this dream, a dream of sharing her mother's stories with the rest of the world so that the world could benefit from those and the ripple effect could be that much larger. So today is part of that dream that that girl, me, I had years ago. And by being here and being present today, you've all, in your own way, made that dream come true. So thank you. Really, really big thank you to all of you who've come to see the work, who are enjoying the work. And today's event really is a thank you event. We've got a wonderful lineup of entertainment. We've got amazing food later on for you. We really just want to thank you all. I hope you enjoyed. You get to meet my lovely mother as well. We get to hear her views directly. So I'm really looking forward to this event. I'll kick off first with a wonderful Kathak performance by Ashmita Tauri. She really is a gifted performer, and she's going to be performing to Ganesh Stuti. Ashmita is a trained classical dancer, and she's a disciple of Guru Padmashri Pratap Pawar. She has recently also branched out in modeling and acting, so you'll probably recognize the face. So please enjoy this performance and put your hands together for Ashmita.
Shubh Karishu Sarva Vada. got a light in my face. A very warm welcome. Thank you for being here today. My name is Caroline Dasmonfray, and I'll be your humble facilitator for tonight. As Sona said, it's all about stories tonight, and it's really, really a pleasure to be hosting this Q&A, to capture some of these stories, capture some of the inspiration that we're here to explore today. So it's my pleasure, my humble pleasure, to welcome you tonight. Can I welcome Sushma, Johari, Madan to the stage, please? Welcome. Sushma, it's a pleasure to have you with us tonight. You are an inspiring artist, an inspiring author, an inspiring teacher. We have so many questions for you. So what we've done before the session tonight is we've captured some questions from all of you, from Facebook. We've tried to get a sense of the stories that we would like to explore today. And we also wanted to kind of get behind the meaning, you know, art and science, those paintings, those words, those beautiful images. So if I could start with a bit of background, what does art mean to you?
Okay, well, let me first welcome to everyone that you all are here in this hot weather, and then I will tell that art meant a lot to me. When I do the artwork, any kind of sculpture, painting, then I feel so relaxed and like a meditating stage. I became timeless, and the art really lot of mean to me, and art gave the direction, the meaning to my life. So I can say that art is my passion.
How many years have you been painting now?
Yeah, it is a difficult question because since childhood I was doing art, and then I left for a long, long time. Then again I started, I think, 10 years back, and my teacher Nick is here. I joined the art classes again because Sona and my all three daughters encouraged me, you do. And they gave me the canvases, and I start doing. Then I thought I should. Then I joined the college.
It's very impressive, and, I have to say. And can you tell us a little bit about what has inspired you?
Yeah, actually everything inspires me. I'm the kind of person that everything inspires me. Small things like if I go somewhere, so greenery, I see the leaves and everything, every single kid, younger people, older people, everything inspires me. And because when I was young, so my mother used to tell me a lot of stories, and I am the youngest child in my family. So my brother and sister, everyone, for me, like a parent, they always tell me the story and traditions. So I follow that traditions, but when I became mother, then I tried to pass that tradition to my daughters, my kids. And when I became grandma, and I trying to pass them, then I feel a big difference. Because when we do the rituals, the traditions, as my mother used to say, we follow. We never questioned that why we are doing this. But this generation, the new generation, is want to reason. The logic, the science behind every tradition, festival, everything. If I want to tell, they want to ask because they feel they are very busy. So why they do this? If some scientific reason is there, logic, then they will try. So Caroline, you do know about Ma Durga?
Yes, I know a little bit about Ma Durga. In fact, I celebrated Durga Puja in Kolkata a few times, so yes,
okay.
Definitely.
So, because we celebrate Navratri, but I did the paintings of nine form of Ma Durga. So in my art college and everywhere, everyone asked why she have so many hands, why she is sitting on the bull, why she is sitting on the donkey, why she is holding this. And those questions start playing in my mind. And I could not sleep properly. I was, because there is a sequence of, they all are the form of Ma Durga, but there is a sequence. You have to follow that sequence. This first day you have to pray Shalputri, second day you have to pray Brahmacharini, third day you have to pray Chandraghanta, fourth day you have to pray Kushmanda. And the question comes in my mind because I read a lot of scriptures and many religious books. Then I found that everywhere is written that fourth day goddess, Devi Kushmanda, who created this universe. Before that, everywhere is darkness. Nothing was here. Then the question comes in my mind, if nothing was there, then why she is on the fourth day? Why should not be she in the first day? And what is the reason behind this sequence of the nine goddesses? And I did lot and lot of research. It took me 4 or 5 years. And my husband, who helped me a lot in this research, and when I found, then I wrote a book on
and,
this.
And that's something that's what makes your art so fascinating, because you bring ancient beliefs, science, art, stories, wisdom together, and it's just so intricate. I think that's what makes it really so special. But you're not just a painter, are you? You've also written a book. And that book, I think, is consistent with the theme we've been highlighting today around how ancient traditions can actually enhance modern lives. Can you tell us a little bit about the wisdom in this book and some of the things that you feel are relevant today?
Yeah, of course. This is a long journey, but I will try to tell you in a few words. I was born in an artist family. So my grandmother used to do art, my father do art, my brother is world known artist, everyone knows. His students are here and everyone knows him. So this was nothing for us. We are doing since childhood art. And I did my degree as well in the art. And after that, when I got the marriage, I left the art. And I don't know why, but I was very fully involved with my kids and decorating my house and things, but I not touch the art. When I, my elder brother used to tell me that again you start the art and drawing and painting, canvas painting, although I was stitching clothes, so art is there, cooking art is there, decorating, but this drawing and painting I left. So after, when I went to India, my younger brother gave me the, in India, you know, there is a small cutting comes in the nine goddesses in Navratri. So he gave me those and he said, please make these paintings for me. So I was not sure, but I took that and I decided to make those paintings and I started to doing. So everyone was asking these questions as I told you before. Then I also found many things. Then I did the research and I found that the science, inner body science, is behind the nine goddesses. Because if you read any book, there is not written anywhere that they born after this and that. The sequence is random.
So are you saying that there's a link between those nine goddesses and the chakras? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, right. Because nine goddesses connected with our chakras. Our sages, our gurus were very intelligent. They did the research and they enlightened themselves. And they found that they can enlighten with the chanting of the mantras. They activate their chakras with the chanting. So they make these mantras, dhyan mantras of the goddesses. They pick the Sanskrit words. If you pronounce that word, the which goddess mantra you will pronounce, the oxygen, the pranavayu will reach up to those nadis. Because the junction of the nadis is the chakra. We used to say the chakra. So we activate that chakra because we cannot take oxygen up to there. A lot of roots are there. Some people do yoga or something, and they take inhale oxygen up to their chakra that become activate. So our sages thought if they make these nine goddesses sequence like this, and attribute of the nine goddesses and attribute of the chakras are the same.
That's amazing.
The first chakra's attribute is the steadiness, and the same is the nine goddesses, is the Shalputri. So if you want to in the detail, you can read my book. So this is the science behind our all religions. Indian culture is very deep. And in the single story, there is behind that, lot of logics and science is there.
I think that's fascinating. So we've got the art, we've got the science, we've got the spiritual side as well, we've got the prana, we've got all of that coming together. We did a poll on Facebook, and we've asked also people in the audience. We asked people, what is, you know, the one painting that you'd like to maybe explore a little bit? People had some questions, and the painting that has been selected, I don't know if we can have it on the screen. There we go. Is yantra? It's sacred art. Can you tell us a little bit about sacred art?
Yeah, this is sacred art. The first thing I will say, this is yantra. The Indians who know the Hindi, they know the meaning of yantra. Not yantra, yantra. I think everyone knows yantra means a machine, a mechanism. So every machine produces something. So this is the yantra. This also produces the energies. And science have proven that every single geometrical shape and images emits very specific energies. So yantra is a group of the geometrical shapes. There is a triangle, a square, circle, dot, everything is there. So they emits very specific energies. And this is Vishnu yantra. So Vishnu is a preserver of this universe, as we think, because Brahma, Vishnu and Mahesh, he is preserver. So if you make this yantra, you will receive the energy of the preserving yourself. So this is the yantra.
It's fascinating. And it's very beautiful as well.
And the yantra, I want to say, this is a scientific art. This is a sacred art as well. Sacred art, everyone knows. But this is a scientific art because science is hidden behind that. Everyone knows we have brain. If we ask people question that in any circumstances, how you take the decision, by heart or by mind. But heart is an organ that pumps the blood, that is not, cannot think. So we have two parts of our brain, left hemisphere and right hemisphere. Left hemisphere work like a thinker, logic, science, maths, and the right brain works with the art and the intuitions and emotions are there. So if people work with the left hemisphere, good, but not perfect. If people work with the right hemisphere, because we have practiced like this, that we always use one hemisphere. Very less people who are enlightened, they work. What is the difference between us and the enlightened people? The same, because they have practiced. Yantra give you the practice. If you make the yantra, this is looking like simple, square and leaf. No, lot of calculation is there, geometrical art. Lot of calculation, you take this, 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 then your left hemisphere start working. Then the leaf will come and you color, then your right brain start working. So yantra trains your mind to work together. So like you join a gym to keep fit your body, you should join the yantra classes, you should make the yantra to keep healthy your brain.
That sounds good, I might just do that.
So this is a science behind the yantra.
So there's so much science and there's just so much symbolism behind this. You also touched on some stories that are kind of foundational, and they link to religion as well. So we've got religion and we've got spirituality. Can you tell me a little bit more about how the two kind of reconcile in your mind? And so what is the difference between religion and spirituality? Is it the same thing?
Yeah, very interesting question. The difference between spirituality and religion. So how can I explain? I can explain you. I take an example, like a huge mountain, big mountain, or like in India, we go to the Vaishno Devi there. You choose any mountain, and the top of there is a soul, that is spirituality. And everyone want to go there. If you have the long journey, you will make the groups. Obviously, you will make the, because on the mountain, some people go from this side, some from this side, some want to go the straight, some go by the helicopter. So their groups will create their own rules that we will do this in the way we will do. So same thing in religion. Religion belongs groups. Everyone's the destination is the peak of the mountain. That is spirituality. The difference between spirituality and religion is that religion makes small groups, and spirituality have the essence of all religions. So this is a big difference. I can explain.
Yeah, that's a great answer. Thank you. It's interesting because I went to Tirupati a few years ago, and there's a bit of a mountain over there. And there's a bit of a journey to get there. And actually, the point of that was not to get to the top; it was the journey to get there, and that was really the spiritual moment. So it does resonate. Thank you. So, you know, we've looked at stories, there's just so much downstairs, you know, each painting has a story, each painting has a spiritual meaning, it links to some, you know, scientific facts, but also to some beliefs that are beautiful in terms of the appeal to the imagination, in terms of the symbolism around the chakra, around so many different things. We've embraced so many topics tonight. If you were to leave the audience with one message, what message would you give?
One message. Yeah, I will give one message. That the what is the present moment, you give your 100% in that. Because that is going to pass. So you should live and give your 100% in the moment where you are living. Life is like a stage play. Like when you go on the stage, you play your role there, and if you gave your 100%, you are satisfied. You have no regretment in your mind in the when your role is finished. But if you went on the stage and you are thinking somewhere else and you are doing your role and something, then you will regret in the end. You say, oh, I could do it better, but I didn't, if I get the next chance. But stage play and the life have no replay and no rewind button. Only what you do is once. So do your best in the present moment so you have no regret in the end of your life that, oh, that time 20 years back, if I did this, that is good. If I do this, no regretment. So only this message I want to give, that live your each and every moment. Give your 100% for the order. Yeah, this is my
fantastic. Well, I think you've given us your 100% with this exhibition. So, Sushmaji, thank you very much.
Thank you, Caroline, and thank you, Sushmaji, my lovely mother. Can we have these chairs off stage, please? Thank you. Right, it's time for our second performance of the day. This really is a spectacular dancer, truly, truly, truly gifted. Our next performer is Sohani Dankimodi. Sohani is a disciple of Guru Dr. Sandhya Parecha. She's an accomplished performer with various gold medals. She's qualified from the Bharat College of Fine Arts and Culture in Mumbai. She's received numerous scholarships and performed in lots of prestigious stages. So we're really, really fortunate to have her here today. So Sohani is also actually a very famous TV actress who played the lead role in the Sony TV soap called For Us. So please put your hands together for Sohani.
Namaskar. My piece today extols the relationship between various art forms. The Vishnu Dharmottar Puran, an ancient text, talks about this interrelationship. King Vajra once wanted to learn the art of iconography so he could make an image of his favorite deity to worship him in the proper form. He goes to sage Markandeya, who tells him that before learning sculpture, you're going to have to learn painting. But to learn painting, you must learn dance. But in order to learn dance, you should have knowledge of instrumental music. But before that, you need to learn vocal music. And thus began his journey of learning the various art forms of India. Vinatu nutya shastrena chitra sutra sudurvidam. Without the knowledge of painting, the knowledge of dance cannot be acquired. Today, I will be depicting this beautiful painting on Shiva, which extols the Mahamrityunjay mantra. To speak to you about the power of this mantra is a beautiful tale of Markandeya, a young devotee of Lord Shiva, who worshipped the Shivalinga ardently. Lord Yama, the god of death, comes at the appointed hour, catches him by the noose, and begins to take his life away. Markandeya holds on to the Shivalinga, embraces the linga, and fearlessly, fearfully recites the Mahamrityunjay mantra. Yama pulls and pulls and tugs, but Markandeya is unflinching in his devotion and tugs on to the Shivalinga, surrendering to him. Lord Shiva emerges from the linga and stops Yama, the god of death, the god of time, thus conquering time itself. This is the power of the Mahamrityunjay mantra, as extolled. This piece also describes various postures of Lord Shiva inspired from sculptures and paintings, a choreography of my guru, Dr. Sandhya Parechachi. I present to you Bho Shambho in Rag Revati and Tal Adi.
Dum, 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 dum ప్రథమం ఆనంద తాండవం ద్వితీయ సంధ్యాతాండవం తృతీయం చతుర్థి
ధిమిత కిట ధిమి కిట కిట
Seriously, wow. Thank you, Suhani, for that truly, truly amazing performance. The painting that was displayed at the back during the performance is downstairs on display, so be sure to go to check it out. But Suhani really, really captured the essence of that painting so well. So thank you once again, Suhani. Beautiful tones. Events like this really take a lot of work, and I found out firsthand this time. It's just not possible by yourself, is it really? It takes a huge amount of effort, a lot of people, a lot of blessings, a lot of supporters of all sorts. And you know, and I really, really thank all of you really to be here. There's three people I'd like to actually formally invite on stage because I just cannot not thank them formally on stage. So I'm going to invite some of you on stage, please, to thank you formally. You're welcome to say a few words. I would love for you to say a few words, but I would not put you under pressure. Okay, so I know who you are. You know who you are, right? So first of all, I'd please like to invite on stage to join me my partner, Arinjum, the rain of the gold rain events. I'm the gold of the gold rain events. Also invite my lovely mother, the artist, please. Sushma, please, can I have you on stage as well? Thank you both for joining me here. The first person I would like to thank from the bottom of my heart for their support, not just by being here today, but support throughout what seems like a lifetime, really. Someone I've admired for a very long time. Someone who personifies purpose, a true, true philanthropist, an inspiration to all of my family, a true gem, and a person who's beautiful inside and out. Serena Neurology, please, can I have you on stage? For an official photo, please, from that side or this side. Thank you.
Thank
today. Hello, everybody. Good evening. I have known Sushma ji for 30 years. I am going to take two to three minutes. Yeah, because I have to say this. I met her 30 years ago. I had just got married and I had two little children. And I went to her house and she had three daughters. They were also sort of 12, 14, 15 here.
Very
little. And I remember this conversation we had. I went and saw this lady who used to sing sometimes, painted, and very skilled. She used to be, making clothes and kept a beautiful house, beautifully decorated. And I sort of admired her quietness, her patience, and just getting on with things. She didn't need any accolades, didn't want any. Still, she was just now saying, why am I going on the stage? I don't want to go. But she has done a wonderful job. Because when we met, she said, I'm worried about their weddings. I've got three girls. And I said, don't worry. They need to go and, work, get a job. They're as good as boys. Yeah, you remember that?
I remember. I was thinking I will get married 18, 19 years. He said, no. gave them nice education. Recalling all the things.
Yeah, I was very young and I was sort of very passionate. And I went and gave her a big lecture about how girls are equal and we are all equal and we should do this. But little did I realize what marriage does to you. Because I used to paint as well. And I used to dance. I learned Kathak. I learned, But the moment I got married, everything got finished. I couldn't pursue the art. I did other creative things, but I haven't painted since. I used to be, But looking at her, that she started 10 years ago, and she's come up with such a beautiful exhibition, I am inspired by you completely. And how well you brought up your girls. Congratulations.
Thank you,
and I'm so honored to be here. Thank you so much for calling
me. I'm honored that you came here.
Thank you so much for inviting me. I just love what you've done.
Thank you.
I hope I ended. Yes, please.
Right, the next person I'm going to invite on stage specifically told me not to, but I will. It's someone who actually showed instant faith in me. Someone who didn't know me at all before a telephone conversation I made where I introduced myself, and there was an instant, yes, I'll do it, kind of response, and I was like, really? I was really taken aback by that, and true to her word, she supported me. She's Smita Sarkar, she's sitting right in front of me. She is also the founder of Global Indian Stories, and a writer, a filmmaker, and a fabulous human being. So Smita, can I invite you on stage? Sorry.
Thank you so much. I mean, I'm really awkward doing these things. So I just want to say that Sona is really an amazing person, and supporting her through this is really something that I'm actually privileged to do. I think it was a beautiful story, and Global Indian Story is basically a diaspora platform. So it's a platform that I created for the Indian diasporas, and I'd love to share stories like this. So it's not just her, but anyone from the group. If you have a good story that you want to share with me, just write to me at smita@globalindianstories.com, or you could write to my co-founder, Jonathan. So that's john@globalindianstories.com, and we'll be very happy to support you. Thank you so much. And at 8:30 today, my slot is between 9 and 9:30. Yeah, between 9 and 9:30, I have a small feature with BBC London Radio. So I'm going to be talking more about Global Indian Stories and how you can get, how you can actually come and join our group. So please, please come and join us and try and tune in. And thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Can we take a picture?
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next person I would like to invite on stage is probably the most down-to-earth Dutchman I've met. He really is only Dutch by birth. I'm sure there's an Indian root somewhere. You know it's you. He is the most talented artist that I've seen. His paintwork is magic. If you haven't seen his paintings, please do. He is a worldwide renowned artist, and it is you, Mr. Peter. Can I please have you on stage? Thank you so much for being here, and especially coming all the way just for one day to be with us and to support us. One of the founding members of the Sanatan Society. Thank you. Make him talk in Hindi.
Only Dora Dora. And Koi Bad Nahi. It was the first mantra I learned when I went to India. My teacher said, say Koi Bad Nahi. And that solved all the problems, also political issues. Yeah, it is anyhow a great honor to be here. And I feel very special that I am invited here.
You are, yeah.
And it reminds me of my teacher.
Yeah, and I think my elder brother was his teacher.
And I think he will be very happy if he sees what the family is all doing here.
Yeah, he always used to tell me, make art. I never think that I can make.
Yeah, so I'm feeling very,
this point is only in my life till end that I will regret that I not paint in front of him. Never. Only he teaches me when I was
That makes
young.
You nervous to paint in front of him.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks, Peter. Especially came from Holland.
My own.
Yeah, I'm grateful that you reached here in time. And
that's for you. Can we
take it? And we can tell about the Sanatan as well.
No.
Okay.
Oh no, it's good.
Sorry.
Give me back, no, it happens. Huh? I gave you, not give me back.
Art is something that needs a lot of support, not just from individuals, but from corporations. Especially large corporations these days invest a lot in art. EY is such one corporation, which I've proudly worked for in the past. We're really fortunate that the EY South Asian Network is one of the sponsors of today's event. I don't know if the EY crowd has made it yet. I know they had left work, but I don't know. I know they were struggling with the heat. So if you are here, can I invite one of you to come on stage, please, if Deepthi is here? If not, I will pass it on to you later on. But thank you so much, EY. Thank you, Deepthi Khurana, who's the head of EY South Asian Network, with her really dynamic and lovely team that support her. Is EY here? Last call. Are you here? Oh, yes, you are! Person. She works as a manager in the forensic team, which makes me scared sometimes of her. But she's an incredible human being who's trying to promote diversity in a workplace and really bring BME and women at the top of the chain. So she's done a lot of work on that, and you continue to promote that. So I'm going to ask you to say a few words about that as well. And thank you for supporting us today. Here you go.
Thank you. I think like Smita, I'm going to be really awkward with this as well. But thank you and congratulations for putting up such an amazing evening and amazing work, Sushma ji. So thank you for your lovely message. We are very proud to be collaborating with you this evening. I would also want to give out a shout out to the rest of my team. We have Tejas, we have Rajshri, Sanita and Zarak here with us as well. So congratulations and an amazing evening. Thank you very much for it.
Thank you. The next person I'd like to invite on stage is a very multi-talented person. I don't think there's anything he can't do, which makes me worried sometimes for my profession. But luckily, he's now stuck onto one, and he's just going on with that one. It's the multi-talented guy who's on the camera. So I'm hoping Vineet, Johri can find somebody to hold onto the camera. He is a movie producer, a photographer, a filmmaker, and an immensely talented person, and a great supporter of us. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Well, I was not prepared for this. This is total surprise for me. Normally, I'm behind the scenes, not in front, but yes, it's a privilege to be here and capture some of the moments from this evening. So congratulations and thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you. The next person I want to invite on stage is probably the most sweetly spoken media person I've come across. She is really a gem of a person. She is from Asian Voice, an editor and a writer. Priyanka Mehta, can we please have you on stage?
To clarify, I'm not the editor. I'm sorry if that's the impression that you got. Congratulations. I haven't had the chance to go down and look at any of the paintings. I'm really sorry about that. But like I saw the performances, I'm pretty sure it must have been really good. And I hope to go down and take a look at them. And congratulations and all the best for the future.
Finally, I'd like to invite on stage the people who will make you very happy later on with their lovely food that they prepare. They are the owners of Patiala Express. They're the most upcoming name in food. Really amazing people. And my sister and my brother-in-law as well, Patiala Express, the main sponsors of today's event. Thank you so much. Can we please have you both on stage?
Everyone, I hope you enjoyed the food. And so good to see Mom on the stage.
Thank you, thank you, thank you all, and thank you for coming on the stage to thank all our guests. The list really is endless. I will thank those that I haven't managed to thank right here, right now on stage. Thank you, Parth. Thank you, Pavan. Thank you, Josh. Thank you to the Goldrain team for always being there, relentlessly working through day and night to help put everything together. I really am humbled by all the efforts, support, good wishes, blessings everyone put into this event. Thank you, Neva. You know, we couldn't have done this without you. Thank you so much. So which really concludes the presentation part of the evening. We have one final lovely performance for you, which really pulls together the essence of the whole exhibition. It's bringing together all traditions, but really embracing the modern times. It's the ARC group, and we will be getting the pleasure of watching Trishna Kumari and Jess Patel perform a lovely Kapha contemporary piece for us. So please put your hands together for our final performance of the evening.
Thank you. mani ta na na re ma re re na na re mani ta na na re ma re re na o dare ta dare na ni ta na na ta de ya na o dare ta dare na ni ta na na ta de ya na ta dare na dare na na re ta na na re ta na na re ta de re na na le da ni ta na na re ta de re na na le da ni ta na na re ta de re na
From us. We'd request you all to make your way downstairs now for some lovely canapes, and also please enjoy the exhibition downstairs. Thank you. Thank you very much.